Today, there are as many as 7 million weblogs or blogs on the internet. Most are run by ordinary people as a hobby. But if corporate America was slow to join the phenomenon, it's quickly catching on.
It's exponential growth, and it's better to be at the front end of that rather than at the back end.
GM and Boeing are two corporations to recently join the blogosphere. General Motors Vice Chairman Bob Lutz launched a blog to rave reviews at the North American International Auto Show in Detroit.
These two new blogs are an indication that business has figured out that open information loops with both enthusiasts and with customers and with employees are a very valuable tool.
Businesses are realizing employee blogs can help put a face on mega corporations. Hundreds of employees at Microsoft, like programmer Robert Scoble, maintain blogs discussing the inner working of the company.
And he has a blog that articulates Microsoft's position, but admits its problems.
What makes them appealing is candor, transparency, speed, and real information. These are the qualities that matter perhaps more than anything else in establishing trust.
Open dialogue creates a potential win-win situation for businesses and consumers alike.
And the company's going to be able to tailor its products and its services more to what customers want.
But companies also worry about employees saying too much on their blog. Many monitor their workers' entries, believing some things are best left unsaid. In New York, Brenda Butner, Fox News.